Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitcher, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. These sectarian riots are killing that's taking place in Iran, Iraq especially, you know, killing Christians, these Islamic, you know, and all that is going to create a lot of problem in the world. You have two things. One is God, in which you love people and you don't kill people. And there is Satan, created by these dog collar priests and mullahs and all those religious leaders seeking their own praises, like Billy Graham and all that. Ian Paisley has died. All that created hatred. And they are Satan of the highest order, as we in God are the sons of the Most High God. So they are in Satan, the sons of the greatest Satan, most destructive Satan. It is called Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa, which when you go to the Hajj, there are four types of Satan there, four types. And the one which is the first day when you throw seven stone, we throw at this Satan, Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa. He is the greatest of all and very powerful. He exploits people in the name of religion, Islam, Christianity, Sikhism, Hinduism, all these are, you know, Jew, all these become sons of Satan. When they become Jew outwardly, Sikh outwardly, Muslim outwardly, not the tribal self, then you are prone to fight and kill each other. What I am preaching is practical, I am giving you, because during the partition of India, we had similar situation, sectarian riots. My father knew this basic subject. So 2,000 people came to attack our village. When he told them, you know, Sikh and Muslim, they are spiritual self inside you and not this one. These are tribal self which are going to fight and kill each other. And we told them we are of Jat tribe and they were of Rai tribe. So when we made them the sons of man, then instead of fighting, you know, the headman of the attacking party told his 2,000 people to look after us as their guest, and they did it. So you can see how the things turned over. They came to kill us. And when we told them we are tribal people going to fight and die, they turned into our best friend in Allah. Most of the people don't know why they call Allah. Even these Mohammedans don't know why they call Allah. So this is the darkness which they have created. So it is our duty, those who have light, to preach gospel from the rooftop. Otherwise you too will be involved. Because if you understand this knowledge and you keep it inside you and don't preach it, then your life is in danger too. Is it more? That is what Christ Thomas said. So if you keep it in your heart, you don't preach it, then it will kill you. So it will kill you if you don't open your mouth and preach. Don't keep sitting on the side. You can't sit on the side. If you listen, understand it, and you don't open your mouth, it will kill you. It's up to you. Here I have something I've written. Prayers and fasting are the killer. Gospel is for life. In Jesus, we have to preach gospel, not prayer and fasting that used to be in old brick-built temples made by human hand. Jesus, with his sacrifice, has shifted us from those brick-built temples and the rabbis that were the ruler to this new temple, which is temple of God, in which our Father lives here, Emmanuel, and we are the sons of the Most High. Our Father is not Lord. Lord was Yahweh and his rulers, Rabbis, who represented Yahweh. We represent our Father God. We are the sons of God. We are the royal priest. They were priests. We have been made royal priests. Jesus is our anointed royal high priest. So we are the virgin brides of Christ Jesus, who is planted in the vineyard of our Father. And that vineyard has a narrow gate only for the solitary, not the wide gate as the used to be in the temple rabbi used to have. Anybody could come and enter. No, everybody, unless you are predestined of our Father, you can't enter the narrow gate. And you have to long for gospel. Gospel is not dished out. It's not something you can go and you can casual. It's not casual. You have to long for it. You have to have a desire. Then you get gospel. It is so sweet to call Jesus a Lord and God and say prayers as if our Father is deaf and dumb, up in the sky, alienated from us, but he is sitting in his own temple here of God, Emmanuel. And you worship God in truth and in spirit. This is important, you know. If you don't love truth, you know, I have been discriminated. Racial discrimination, I've been victim, you know. And these people who have, most of them, you know, they have told lies to discriminate. So you can see, this is Europe in which, you know, people are supposed to be more receptive to gospel. And they can't speak the truth, or they are discriminating because of the color. So you can see what will happen in Iran, Iraq, and other places in the East. They will be much more greater. That's why the light is there in the India, but it won't shine there because they are greedy. In greed, they tell lies. When they tell lies, gospel can't come near them. So in spirit means what is inside should be outside. No hypocrisy. No hiding anything. Truth. All should be out. Like little children. Unless you become like little children, you can't enter into the royal kingdom of God. And no more in prayers. We don't worship our Father in prayers, etc. As Jews did in the temple made by human hands. You know, the Jews were praying in the temple made by human hands, where Yahweh was Lord and alienated. Rabbis kept him alienated. But our Jesus, through sacrifice, as the Lamb of God, he has united us with our Father, Emmanuel. Lords have slaves. Lords have slave disciples, as the rulers, rabbis had, and Jesus set us free of their clutches through his word. If you don't have his word, you are not free. You will be still going to those dog collar priests, which are worse than those rabbis, as mentioned in Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. The arid temple priest, you know, the arid evil spirit of the temple priest entered into the churches of God and polluted them, corrupted them. They corrupted the New Testament as well. Today you have hireling dog-collared priests in the churches, worse than those hypocrite rabbis. Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. Sectarian riots, as in Iraq, killing, you know, their own tribal people, they are killing each other. As I said, during partition, we killed also our own tribal people, taking them of a Hindu and Sikh and Muslim. But my father knew the subject, and he spoke. He set them made them friends, you know. Same, you too can make them friends if you speak. If you shut your mouth and don't have longing for gospel, you will die like flies, swines, because you are unfaithful to your tribal father and to our father in nature, Yahweh. So you have to be faithful to tribal and to Yahweh, then you are faithful to our father in spirit. Sectarian riots in Iraq are created by the super blind, hireling, dog-collared priests working for Mammon and not for God. They are hypocrite. And you need to be solitary virgin bride of our bridegroom, Christ Jesus. You have to graft yourself to the true wine, Christ Jesus, and suck the juice out. That is our feed. Listen to him through the ears and then speak it from your mouth, for drinking the blood of Christ, eating the flesh of Jesus and drinking the blood of Christ. For details, visit my over 4,000 YouTube videos, channel Niger One. You cannot blame Hitler for the Holocaust, but the clever Jews themselves who rejected Jesus as their Messiah. The only lost sheep, you know, out of the 100, one was lost, and that sheep was people of Judah tribe. And they are the one who became Jews. The other tribal people did not change their tribe. But these people of Judah tribe, they changed their tribal identity to Jew. Jew, they became outwardly. Jew is one who is inside. When they became Jew outwardly, they are bye-bye to their tribal father. And they have become super bastard, you know. That's why Jesus told them when sitting in the temple, when they had caught a woman caught in adultery, that would have just produced bastard, you know. That Jesus mentioned in Matthew 19, some eunuchs were born of the womb of the woman. That was the bastard born of the prostitutes. And they caught the woman, you know. But Jesus was of supernatural father. So he told them in the temple that your fathers are super bastard devils. Now he used this word, super bastard devils. So when he told them super bastard, you know, then the Jew said, are you a Samaritan? Then say, we are not bastards. We are sons of our legitimate fathers. We are not son of the legitimate father. We are not born as bastard, you know. Jesus called them super bastard, you know. But these messianic Jews, they took that words away from the Bible, you know, so that make it less harsh, you know. Because the gospel is bitter, and it's a bitter pill that cures and takes you to salvation. There's no more heaven. In Jesus we get salvation, resurrection, and not reincarnation. Reincarnation in works are the Rabbis. They became Jews outwardly, unfaithful to Abraham and Yahweh. No protection from Abraham or Yahweh. If they are unfaithful, he kicks them out. Protection to the faithful to Abraham and Yahweh, Samaritans, who became apostles in great numbers. But the clever Jews, on occupying the church of God, killed them by throwing before the animals or to be burnt alive. When they had this Emperor Constantine in their hand, with their sycophant they are. They praised him, you know, they made him like God, you know. And when they made him God, he got big-headed, arrogant. They made me God. So he did what they told him to do. The Jews, light came among them, among the people of Judah tribe, but they loved darkness. So when they love darkness and they become super blind, when the blind guide lead the blind, they fall into the pit of Holocaust. So who is to be blamed? Hitler or those blind people who rejected Christ? So Hitler did not kill anyone. It is our father killed them. And Yahweh, their own Abraham, and their own Yahweh killed them, and not our father God. Because they were unfaithful to him, he said they are good for nothing, tares. Now they are getting bundled up for the final burning. So they were thrown burnt alive, you know, as Pope was burning people at stake. Anyone who stands between man and God is Antichrist. All these dog-collar priests, all these pastors in the churches, Pope, etc., are Antichrist. Are in Sikh temple, these jathedars and leaders, mullahs in mosque, they are Antichrist. Blind guides of the blind disciples. They call them disciple is the word from discipline. You discipline a natural once-born man through moral laws. We are not under law, we are under spirit. So we are twice born, laboring sons of the Most High Father. Or we are the brethren, I am the younger brother of Christ Jesus. He is my elder, anointed elder brother. So we are brethren. I went to Bonhoeffer organization in Germany. They had a hospital. And I asked them, why don't you call God Lord, you know? No, he is our father. So they have more sense, you know. But you know these people who are of Satan, who call Jesus a Lord and God and everything, they hate them. Because they are not part of them. As in England, the Church of England people, they hate Salvation Army people. Because the William Booth, he looked after the poor and rejected. Whereas these rich people of Church of England, they suck the blood of the poor. And they went overseas to kill people for the sake of money, and when their soldiers died, they say, hey, our soldiers glorified God. What type of God was that? A Church of England headed by Queen. Queen is head of Mammon. So Mammon is their God, not our God, which is spirit. So they are making fool of the people. And you know, these are white people in general, especially English. They are still notion in their head that they ruled India. When they ruled India, and they still feel that we are superior to these black people. And I have a very bad experience, you know, recently. I used to go to a gym, you know, and over there, 20, 30 years girls, you know, she called me, come here like this, with this finger. I reported to them, to the manager. He did nothing because she was white and he is white. So I'm being black. I was just, you know, hey, off you go. And I've been pushed out of that one by a small incident, which is their own fault, you know. Somebody was standing in front of the customer where he should be. And she was a lady, I tapped on her bottom, you know, get out away, I want to have my blood pressure checked. Oh, you touched me. And then next day they throw me out. So I'm happy, you know, I'm out. Now I go to the university, it's just around the corner, and I play tennis, I meet happy people. So these people, you know, British, they are miserable people. And these miserable people, when they get on the head, you know, you get injustice. And no wonder, you know, when I had the boundary dispute, the council, Reading Council, all that, you know, they did favor to the neighbor. And these council surveyor, you know, I paid them and they did favor to neighbor. That means they gave him the chance to occupy my encroachment, you know, our land at my own expense. Stupid people, no justice, you know. So there are so many things, I will put a video on that one, all that, once the things get settled, you know. So this is the mentality of the British people. Even that's why I understand when I go to Oxford University, you know, to tell them these things, you know, they still think that these black people have no brain, and they being white, you know, they are more knowledgeable. So I get hatred, you know, I can see them, they don't like me, you know, but they won't say it openly. Then who will suffer? They won't get any knowledge, you know, and they are creating these blind guide of the blind student, you know, putting their dog collar around, making them blind guide, working for money. And when sectarian riots come, then they are to be blamed. Never mind, you know, our Father is with us. All these priests, pastor, pope are antichrist, blind guides of the blind disciple. In Jesus, we are his laboring brethren of Jesus with one Father God, or Elohim, and not of Yahweh of nature, in which you have your own tribal fathers. In Yahweh, we have own tribal fathers. So with this, you know, I will leave it. My telephone rang. Never mind, it stopped. Okay, our Father God bless you. So I will urge you to please preach gospel, because this is the end of the world is coming. The tears are getting bundled up in Israel. In 2018, there will be atomic war expected. And in 2016, 2 years before the atomic war, the people, Jewish people, will be rushing to Israel as they rush to Jerusalem when the temple was destroyed in 70 AD. People all over the world will start killing them, because what they are doing in Gaza and other things, you know, Middle East, they have destroyed it. So everything they, when the world will see, they won't love them. And there are nice people among Jewish people. So I urge them, you know, to come forward and let's preach gospel with hand joined together. They are far better than our Indian people, because they are not that greedy as Indian. Remember that the Jewish people hated the Samaritans. Samaritans are the descendant of Joseph. And because Joseph was faithful to Abraham and to Yahweh, so the Samaritan land is more productive than the chosen people land, 11 other crook brothers. Because it is productive, so they are jealous, you know, to see that, hey, this land is very productive, our land is not, because this is a special land, promised land, which is given to Abraham. Anybody who is faithful to Abraham and to Yahweh, he will get the blessing of our Father God as well as of Yahweh. Yahweh in India we call him Brahma, and God we call him Parbrahm. So there are two different gods, one of nature, one of soul. But these people don't know. One is nature is like natural man, jealous and revengeful. Spiritual man, loving and merciful, the opposite in nature. But these university people, they are arrogant, men of letters, desiring not the new wine. So they are to be blamed for all these things happening in the world. Our Father God, bless you.